Actually, I first did an open records. And they
All right, so they're going back and forth. That was really interesting, actually. We got to see how the original text messages between the divorce attorney for Nathan Wade and also his former law business partner was texting with this attorney for Trump co-defendant, Ashley Merchant. And so now that we get to see when they were opened, what dates they were sent, I mean, it's all out there and easy to understand. Senior correspondent Jonathan Sary is at the Georgia State Capitol in Atlanta. He's been watching, as we have been, and monitoring since the hearing began. Jonathan, what can you tell us that specifically stands out at this point to you?
Yeah, well, the Senate committee hearing is learning more details about what defense attorney Ashley Merchant says she was able to learn about the romantic relationship between District Attorney Fannie Willis and Nathan Wade, her special prosecutor in the Georgia election interference case. Let's listen to some highlights.
He said that they met at a judicial conference before, he was very specific that it was before she became DA, because that was one of the things that he couldn't remember when the judicial conference was, but he knew that it was before she became DA. And he told me, you know, they met at hotels, he would go to her place, and I remember him saying, you need to find her her bestie who they had a falling out, that's the person whose condo it was that they would meet at.
Ashley Merchant is an attorney representing former Trump campaign aide Mike Roman. Roman, who was a co-defendant of the former president, had filed a motion with Merchant to have D.A. Willis removed from the case. A judge is expected to rule on that by mid-March. Now, the committee chairman today asked Merchant whether she had reason to believe that Willis or Nathan Wade were coordinating with the Biden White House over the course of the Trump investigation. Listen.
Open records for the White House access, and we had records that Ms. Willis and the mayor of Atlanta were at meeting with the vice president.
Fannie Willis and Nathan Wade have testified that they did not become romantically involved until after she hired him to help investigate the Trump case in November of 2021. But as you heard from Ashley Merchant's testimony earlier today, the defense is alleging that the romance started much earlier than that. Harris?
So, Jonathan, I just want to get this straight because I've got a former U.S. attorney coming up next. And I want to make sure I have my facts straight. What was the deal with the meeting at the White House? Did you say the Vice President Kamala Harris?
Said that several people were meeting at the White House. Of course, the nature of that meeting was not expressed. It could have been some Democratic event or a social
event. But
who was
in it?
But the implication that they're trying to get at was that allegedly there may have been some coordination with this case, but they don't have any hard evidence of that at this point, because the receipts, and this is something that Ashley Merchant pointed out, that Nathan Wade submitted are very vague. They just mentioned that he met with White House counsel or met with White House, but doesn't go into any detail as to what the meetings were.
Okay, I got it. Thank you, Jonathan Sary. Great reporting.
Certainly.
Brett Tolman, former U.S. attorney and former Senate Judiciary Committee counsel. I do want to drill down just a second on the White House meeting and how that comes into play. Is that purely politics, or as a former U.S. attorney, is it something that you look at as information? What?
Well, I will tell you, I think you're right to be asking questions about it. And here's what the public needs to understand. There's really no circumstance for the White House counsel or anyone in the White House to go anywhere near this if their goal is to make sure that it is an objective review of potential criminal activity of an opponent, of a political opponent. If, however, you are coordinating and you're wanting to take down a political opponent, that's temptation that the White House, I think, probably gave into, was to have conversations and look at the four different criminal cases. All of them have access, and we're learning that most of them at this point have had conversations with the White House just prior to charges being brought. That's not coincidence. That's coordination.
Yeah. All right. I wanted to hit that because that seems to be a bigger issue now that we're hearing about it in a different venue. A state Senate committee, special committee hearing. And now you get into what you just pointed out, two men battling it out. And it takes me back to what Donald Trump said days ago when his U.S. Supreme Court victory happened. 9-0, you can't keep his name off a ballot. No state can do that. What he said was, stop using your high power, President Biden, of the DOJ, and let's fight this out between the two of us. It's very interesting to put that in the context of, was Nathan Willis, was Fonnie Wade, was anybody, or excuse me, Nathan Wade and Fonnie Willis, was anybody on that prosecutorial team, particularly those two lovers, talking with anybody at the White House? So it is interesting. I'll continue to ask the question. All right, real quickly, your top line about what's come out today and when they met and what matters.
Well, I think there's folks that have been saying for some time now, what's the big deal? Why, you know, so what? So they have an affair. Does that really impact the underlying criminal investigation? Here's why it does, Harrison, why it's so important. You have a legitimate inquiry into the ethics of the sitting DA. You have to know whether or not there's a compromise to those ethics, because that brings into question her prosecutorial discretion, whether she was capable of exercising it appropriately. Then when she lies about their affair, now you have a bigger issue. Now you have potential obstruction of justice. Right now, what should be happening in the next few weeks, you should have a criminal investigation opened for obstruction of justice and an ethics investigation for lawyers who are willing to lie in the courtroom.
Brett Tolman, always great to have you. Thank you very much for handling the breaking news.
Thanks, Harris.
Hey, everyone. I'm Emily Campagno. Catch me and my co-hosts Harris Faulkner and Kaylee McEnany on Outnumbered every weekday at 12 p.m. Eastern, or set your DVR. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the Fox News YouTube page for daily highlights.